Hello guys, welcome to today's session. So today we will discuss about one build tool called Maven. So let's start. So today we will cover below topics, overview of Maven, then Maven environment setup, then what is Maven POM, then we will discuss about Maven build lifecycle, then what are the repositories for Maven, then we will discuss about the plugins. Then we'll you know, learn how to create a Java project using Maven. Then the about the how we can create a project document using Maven. Okay. So overview of Maven. So Maven is a build automation and reporting tool used primarily for Java project. Actually, Maven is a build automation tool. So through which you can build, you know, build the code. Okay, so there is so many build tool available like Ant. Okay, so but Maven is very popular and specially used for Java project only. Okay, so Maven uses convention over configuration, which means developers are not required to create build process themselves. Developers do not have to mention each and every configuration detail. Maven provides sensible default behavior for projects. When a Maven project is created, Maven creates default project structure. Developer is only required to place files accordingly, and he and she need not to define any configuration in pom.xml. Actually, why Maven uses convention over configuration? That means there is standard a format. Like when you are creating a project, okay, that time it will have some standard folder structures. So that means where my source code will be placed, where my test code will be placed, where my resources will be placed, where my jar file will be placed. So it is only the standardized only. Okay, so main use cases, if main benefit of uses of Maven is like if a team member joins, okay, in a project. Okay, so he or she need not to worry about the structure, all those things, because Maven maintain the standard structure, standard folder file folder structures only. Okay, so the main benefit, but other build tool that doesn't, you know, maintain the folder structures. Okay, so if you can see, so item source code, there will be some standard directory /src/main/java. So all source code will be come under this directory. Then resources will come under src main, then resources, then the all test code. Okay, when the build will happen, that time all the test code will happen, will be placed on /src/test. Then jar file, when the build will complete, then the jar file or var file will be placed under the /target. So this is the standardized, you know, folder structures. Okay, so now we will discuss about the Maven environment setup. So how we can set up the environment. So first we need to install Java 1.5 or higher in the machines. Okay, then we need to set the environment for the Java. Okay, and then need to set the system path. Then we need to download the archive file of Maven, then extract the Maven archive. Then we need to set the environment variable as well as the directory path location, Maven bin directory location to system path. Okay, so this is the four steps we need to follow. So when I will do the, you know, lab session, so that time, you know, I will show you the Maven environment setup, how you can set up the environment for the Maven. So Java is must. Okay, so two packages needed, one is Java, another is Maven. So we need to install Java, need to set the environment, again we need to extract the Maven archive, then again we need to set up the environment variable and the system Maven, you know, directory location to system path. So these four things need to do. So I will show you in the lab session. Then Maven project object model. So what is POM? A POM is the fundamental unit of work in Maven. It is an XML file that contains information about the project and configuration details used by Maven to build the project. So POM is a XML file. So you can you can tell as it is a brain actually. So what are the configurations, we have make entry in the POM file. So as per that, as per the configuration, the build process will happen. So there is no need to create POM file manually. Basically, when we will create a project, that time the POM file will create by default only. The folder structure, all folder structures, POM file, all those things will be created. There is no need to create manually. Okay. So a POM file requires the project element and three mandatory fields. So group ID, artifact ID, and version. So the POM file, when you will create a project, that time you need to give group ID, artifact ID, and version name. Okay. So if here you can see that group ID, this is my group ID, then artifact ID and this project ID, then the version name, and the package is jar file. So when the build will be complete, that means my package will on the package will be in the jar format only, dot jar. So if I want to create in dot var also, so you can, here we need to give the var. Okay, so my my code will be built in the var format only. Okay, dot var file. Okay, for deployment. So then here if you can see dependency, so this is the total example of POM dot, how POM dot XML looks like. So this is the looks like. Okay, so dependency, so dependency mean when you are doing the build, that time so many dependencies is needed. Okay, so as per the your archetype actually. So what is archetype, I will show you now. Okay, in the next slide we will cover that thing. So that time, suppose I am building a Java application which is JUnit package is needed. Okay, so JUnit, so where it will get actually? So here is the, these are the dependency, like JUnit is needed, then the some packages SLF4 J hyphen API also needed. So it will, when you will, it will build, so it will automatically downloaded from the repository. So what are the repository, I will discuss in the next slide. Okay, so these are the dependency what are the dependencies required to build the project. So automatically will download from the repository. Okay, so this is the this is the example of a pom.xml file. So then we will cover the Maven build lifecycle. So build lifecycle is a well-defined sequence of phases which define the order in which the goals are to be executed. Okay, so when we will do building, we will start the build. Code building. So that time it will it will cover all phases. Like first phase will be the prepare resources. Means what are the resources is needed to build the project. Then the second is the, after all the resource gathered, then the compilation will happen. Okay, source code compilation will be done. Then after that, packaging. So packaging will happen, the phase create jar or var package as mentioned in the package. I saw you right in the last slide, pom dot. So whether my packaging will happen in form of jar or var file, so whatever whatever we have given in the pom dot xml file, accordingly it will convert that file to whether it is jar or whether it is var. Then installation, the phase install the package local or remote. After packaging, the file needs to be copied to somewhere else, that means some application server, the application need to be deployed in the somewhere else, right? So that is the installation phase. Then Maven repositories. Maven terminology, repository is a place, directory where all the projects, jar, library, jar, plugin, or any other project specification are stored and can be used by Maven easily. That means when you are doing the build, actually, when we are doing the build, so there is so many dependencies needed, like JUnit package or any other dependency. Okay, depend on the archetype actually. So where Maven will build the, when we will download that packages which is needed for the build. So there will be three type of repository. One is local repository, central, and remote. Okay, so there will be local, central, and remote. Okay, So local repository, what is local repository? Maven local repository is a folder location on your machine. It gets created when you run any Maven command for the first time. Okay, Maven local repository keeps your project all dependencies like library, what are the libraries is needed, jar file, plugins, all those things. When you run Maven build, then Maven automatically download all the dependency jars into the local repository. Okay, so it helps to avoid references to dependencies stored on remote machine every time a project is built. So first, you know, when the preparation phase, when you will, you know, start the building, so first what are the dependencies required, first it will look at in the local repository. Okay, then the central repository. Okay, Maven central repository is repository provided by Maven community. It contains a large number of commonly used libraries. Okay, when Maven does not find any dependency in the local repository, it starts searching in central repository. Okay, so first when the build process will start, that time what are the dependencies required, first it will search in the local repository. After that, when if the dependencies is not found in the local repository, then it will search from the, it will try to download from the central repository. Okay, then third is remote repository. Sometimes Maven doesn't find a mentioned dependency in a central repository also, so it stops building process and output another message to console, so the dependency failed. Okay, then build will be failed. To prevent such situation, Maven provide concept of remote repository, which is developer own custom repository contain required libraries and project. Suppose, you know, Maven unable to find in the local repository as well as the central repository, then third thing, okay, then some, in some projects developer has created some remote repository from where the, when the build time, what are the dependencies required, it will try to, you know, pull the, try to download that dependency to the local repository. Okay, so so what are the, you know, so in the .pm.xml file, so these are the paths the developer will mention. Okay, so that means, you know, that is artifact id is common, ILAB version is this. So from where it will download .companyname.org Maven tutors, in this URL this package will be available. So in the pom.xml file, developer has to, you know, somebody has to make an entry, these are the dependency and their location from where it will download. Okay, then this Maven dependencies for sequence, how will search? We have already discussed, right? Local, first it will try from local repository, then the central repository, then the remote repository. So first search dependency in local repository, if not found, move to step 2, else if found, then do the further processing. Then search dependency in central repository, then the remote repository. Okay, so first it will search in the local, then the central, then the, you know, remote repository. If in the three repository not found, then the build process will not go further. Okay, it will stop there, it will throw an error, dependency failure, these are the dependencies needed. So again we need to make an entry in the pom.xml file, what are the dependencies needed. Okay, then Maven plugin. So also, you know, Maven is actually plugin execution framework where every task is actually done by the plugin. So whatever jar file is creating or war file is getting created or compilation, so everything depend on the plugins only. Okay, then the creating Java project using Maven. So I will show you here. So when we will do the lab session, that time I will, you know, I will build one project actually. That is the, you know, I have given here one example of actually. Maven uses archetype plugin to create projects. So if you will see mvn archetype underscore generate. Okay, this is the command. When you will create a project, you have to give the command like this, mvn archetype underscore generate. Then it will ask for the group ID information. So why group ID is needed? Suppose I have large project, right? So there will be so many artifact will be there. So under one group there will be multiple artifact. Okay, so there is three things need to provide. One is group ID, second is artifact ID, third thing is the version name and the archetype actually. Okay, it will ask when you will create a project, that time for three things you need to give. One is group ID, then the artifact ID, then the version number, then the your archetype. Okay, so group ID is this, artifact ID is my project ID, then the archetype ID. So architect, suppose I want to build simple Java application. So that time there will be one archetype. Okay, so there will be so many archetype. You have to give in the numbers only, these numbers. Okay, so I want to build, my application will be the Spring, using Spring or Hibernate. So accordingly, you have to give the that name. Okay, so it will list all the archetype. So you have to choose that thing. Okay, then the project will created, all the directory structure, all those things will be, and form.xml file will be created. Okay, then Maven project document. So I told you, right? So one is it will build also, and it will Maven also, you know, prepare a document for you, project document. Okay, so once build done, then you have to go to the project folder. You have to go inside to the project folder. Then you have to run mvn site, mvn space site command. Then it will, prepare a full document for you, project document. So it will help you to, present this document to the client. Okay. So thank you very much, guys. So in the next session, I will share the all the labs. We'll do the all the labs like installations, then setup. We'll create a one projects. Okay. So how to build. So these are the things I will show in the lab sessions. So if you like this video, so please subscribe to my channel for all cloud technologies related videos. Then DevOps, then system admin. So I will keep uploading.